courses we all learned that first year. I have a long way to go to become the teacher that I aspire to be. So I did what I could to enhance my practice. Little by little, I grew. But after a while, that growth kind of stalled. I started feeling disengaged, like I was doing the same thing day in and day out. I had become far too dependent on assessments, and I had started teaching to the test, something I promised myself I would never do. I had officially lost my passion for teaching. But somebody saw me defeated, saw my frustration, someone who knew the me that I was meant to be. She sought me out. She started slowly at first, just giving me ideas of things that I could do in my classroom to enhance my practice. And she invited me to remember why I was here, my students. And I began to remember how much I really loved this job. She then tried to push me a little further to pursue national board certification. I told her I wasn't ready, so she waited. As years went by, things began to change in my district and probably many of yours as well. I was now facing an evaluation system that had me reconsidering my commitment to education. And seriously considering how I would manage to say an accountant or a landscaper, because anything had to be better than this. Again, she saw me. She reminded me that a score on a piece of paper does not define me. I was impacting kids. That was all that mattered. She then gently reminded me about the National Board Certification process, and I was so ready. I needed something to excite me, to help me enhance my craft. And of course, she was there mentoring me through that process. While I saw myself as a good teacher, she knew I was a great one, and she made me own it. She also encouraged me to begin mentoring new teachers in my district, and even helped me find professional development opportunities that would help me enhance my skill. Her belief in me never wavered, even when my belief in myself did. But of course, she didn't stop there. As I complained about the educational system and all the problems that I saw, she challenged me to do something about it. Again, she saw something in me that I hadn't seen in myself. She knew I was a leader, and I was beginning to see myself through her eyes. So I decided to create a local association to give teachers in my district a voice in a way that they hadn't had before. I began to bargain for them, advocate for their needs, listen to their worries. And I've created something that I hope will live on in my district long after my tenure has ended. I believe in myself as their leader. Now, it's not an unwavering faith like the one she has for me, but I do believe in myself and my ability to lead. And if I forget, if I start to doubt myself, she is there, reminding me why I have to fight the good fight, why I can't wait for somebody else to step up to the plate. I have learned that one person's belief in you can alter the trajectory of your career, of your leadership experience, of your life. It's like that old quote, to the world you may be one person, but to one person you may be the world. All of us in here have had somebody believe in us, commit in us, push us to our fullest potential to become the people that we are today. And it is our responsibility now to believe in someone else, because everyone deserves to have someone commit to their future, maintain that unwavering faith in their potential. I had no idea 9 years ago in that kindergarten classroom that I would be the teacher, the advocate that I am today. But somebody believed in me. We need to be that someone, because change truly begins with us.